Hey horse people, I think I did a video on this a long time ago and for some reason I can't find it or it was taken down or something. So you see this guy bringing the water buckets here, walking, and he walks to the right of this cone. So why is this cone out in front of those horses? Okay, we call this a clue. It's out of the place, it's out of ordinary. This guy walked around the cone. Why didn't he walk by the horsey? Call that a clue. This guy walks by. Doesn't go on the inside of the cone. Two men talking. Most men I've seen at a barn, and I don't know how long. I don't know where this barn's at. Anyway, so the guy's getting water, and he's got, I guess they got to bring water to their horses. They don't have water to the horse, so they got to bring it in buckets. So this guy's going back here getting water buckets. You see right back here, he's filling up his water buckets. And Mr. Cone, Cone Lives Matter, this poor cone did nothing. It's about to get attacked for no reason, knocked over, slammed into the dirt. Probably ought to be wearing a helmet, but there's no safety requirement for cones to wear helmets. Ow, ow, what the, ow. Damn cone, look at that, poor cone, that's cone abuse. That cone didn't do anything, look at it. Okay, so what happened here? Quite a few things. So I'll go back and kind of show this. First of all, this cone is here, which is not very marked, because this horse is trapped into the stall and probably hates his life, probably doesn't get out, probably has an owner that has somebody else throw it food and water. So it has learned for entertainment that my only safe space is in here. And this is the only place that I can entertain myself, so he attacks people as they walk by. And I gotta say, it's not really that aggressive attack. I mean, he tried to bite the guy and he hit him with his jaw, but it wasn't like he grabbed him and tried to pull him into his stall so he could stomp him, which he could have done if he wanted to. But he just kind of peeks his head out here and kind of plays, you know, the gotcha game. He tries to bite, then the person tries to hit him, and he's quicker than the person, so he backs away, and then the person leaves, and another person comes by, and he tries to bite, and he tries to hit him, and it becomes a game. Well, unfortunately, games get people hurt and get horses labeled as bad, dangerous, mean, etc. So, first of all, this guy who owns this horse hasn't got this marked very well. This guy isn't paying attention. He kind of lost focus because he was yielding to this guy with a horse coming through here. This guy's not paying attention. He has two buckets. He's not looking at the horse. Now people are going to say this horse is sneaky. He laid in wait. The horse has no choice. He's stuck in his stall 24 hours a day. What, I mean, he's got nothing else to do but look at this. If you were on my gun channel, you'd know what a fatal funnel is. This horse has learned this door is a fatal funnel. And anybody that walks by has to walk by this door. This is the only place that he can get them. So he waits, and he goes after this guy. And he just hits him in the shoulder. He actually doesn't bite him. The guy kind of dents his head. Now this poor horse, he ain't doing nothing but being led by another owner with his head stalled, has no choice. Doesn't, you know, can't yield, can't get warnings from another horse, can't, he's just out here minding his own damn business, and this guy's gonna attack him. Rick, he's not attacking him, he just fell. The horse don't know that. The horse is like, hey, I'm walking, you see these ears, see this ear pointing to this horse? This horse knows what's going on. A horse knows what's gonna happen before it happens. So this horse knows, hey, this dummy's about to get bit. Good, another stupid human. Get him, horse. I'm with the horse. This horse is with the horse. I'm with the horse. So this horse bites this guy, and when he falls, he kind of knocks the cone over. The two buckets go. This horse is kind of like, hey, this doesn't look good. The stupid human is kind of looking back like, hey, just what happened? The horse already knows what happened. He's ready to respond. He's like, holy shit, something's trying to grab this poor little horse. He's like, dude, I didn't do nothing. I'm just walking here by my own damn business trying to make a living. And this dude attacked me for no reason. And then this cone attacked me. And then this guy threw a bucket at me. Yeah, shit, I'm just here minding my own business being led by my owner. So this guy dropped his buckets. He fell over the cone. This horse, if you watch him, this owner really starts leaning and call what I call sitting on a rope, trying to stop this horse from backing up, because this horse is like, hey, I don't know what the hell happened, but I'm getting the hell out of it. Now, every time this horse walks by this cone from now on, he's gonna be like, that damn cone attacked me last time I walked by it. I gotta be careful. Last time I walked by this cone, some stupid human jumped off the wall, tried to grab my back feet, and this cone tried to attack me. So this horse just learned. Now, horses learn very quick lessons, but they can unlearn them just as quick. That's the beauty of them. If you do it right, you can fix this. But if this guy beats his horse every time the horse walks by the cone and acts scared, the horse is going to learn, not only does the cone attack me when I'm by it, but now my owner attacks me when I walk by the cone. So a lot of people watching this video will want to focus on this horse biting this stupid human, which I don't really have a problem with. I mean, the owner should mark this off better. It should be marked. I mean, I would put yellow tape to the cone, and I would really block this off. Maybe he tried that and somebody complained that this ain't your aisle, blah, 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 blah. You need to muzzle your horse. You should chain him up. You should get rid of him. But, you know, ain't no telling what the barn dynamics are on why this cone is here and it's such a poorly marked thing. But obviously some people know, because out of 4, 5, 6 people that walk by, this guy's the only dummy that got bit. So anyway, now watch this guy really sit on this horse's face trying to stop him. I mean, this horse, he is just leaning back and just on that horse's face. Now, you notice the stupid human behind. This is just so many great stupid humans. So let's go back to the poor horse getting attacked. So right here, the horse is like, well, this ain't normal. A cone's attacking me, a guy's attacking me. I got to get out of the way and turn around. Remember, horses cannot see behind them. They have monocular and binocular vision. When they use their monocular looking side to side, this eye on the left sees what's on the left, the eye on the right sees on the right, but they don't really have good focus. It's shades and shadows. That's why they spook a lot. So for a horse to focus on something, he has to look at it, go to binocular vision using both eyes by, and he has to move his head up and down to focus on the object so he can figure out what it is. And that's why tie downs, martingale, all this other crap, bits, pains, pulling, roll cur, all this crap, is just totally goes against any logic for a horse to be able to see, respond, and learn instead of reacting to the pain of the freaking stupid humans. So this horse's first instinct is, I have to turn around and focus on what tried to attack me. Now, if he didn't have a lead rope on, he'd have probably just took off running and mowed this guy down. And he almost mows this guy down anyway. So this guy's getting a clue right about now, like, shit, this horse is putting his ass to me. That's a clue. I should move. So he moves, just barely missing. He still could get a good kick right here if the horse wanted to kick him. This guy back here is kind of figuring out what's going on, and he's looking and almost moving toward the horse till the horse starts coming back and he sees a guy out of control, and he gets a clue and says, shit, I better bail into my little safety zone. Meanwhile, this owner is sitting on this horse's face. This horse is like, why the hell did this cone and stupid human attack me? And now we go back to the other stupid human, and this stupid human is upset. His ego's hurt. His pride's hurt. He's muddy. He's not real happy. I get it. He blames the horse, and he takes it out on the horse, and he reinforces everything the horse has learned about humans coming by my door. They either beat me, they try to hit me, they throw hay at me, they put a chain on me, they hurt me, and now they throw water in my face. Everything the horse has learned, he's learned from the stupid human. All right, hopefully you got something out of that. We'll end that there. Poor little horse.